Hi guys, in this video I'm going to show you how easy it is to stream from a camera that has a built-in live streaming encoder. Now for this example I'm going to be using the Panasonic CX350, but of course fundamentally it's the same steps regardless of what camera you're using, providing it has a live streaming encoder built into it. So first things first, you need to get your camera connected to the internet. Of course, there's no way we can stream if we don't have an internet connection. So on the back of this camera, I have an Ethernet port, which you might on your camera as well, or you'll have Wi-Fi connectivity. Now on this camera, I've got a little Wi-Fi USB dongle, and on the side here, I've got a little port where I can put that in. Now this camera has wireless connectivity. So if you're going to connect to the internet through that Ethernet port on your camera, then if you're going straight into a router that already has internet connection, then usually you don't need to do any other settings in terms of getting that camera talking to the internet, you know, the wider world. It will just automatically connect, much like when you plug in a computer or a laptop directly into a router. However, if we are using wireless, then we're going to have to find the wireless network that we want to connect to and obviously put the password in for it, and then the camera can connect to it. So let's turn the camera on. And I'm going to be using my phone's personal hotspot for this, just to make it nice and straightforward. And of course, then at the end of it, we'll have a truly mobile solution. So my personal hotspot is on. I'm just going to go into the menu of the camera. And you want to look out for something along the lines of network or wireless settings. For this camera, it's actually called WLAN. And WLAN just means a wireless local area network. Of course, that's what we want to tweak. And then you're looking for something that says network name, or it may be called SSID. Your camera will usually then just scan to see what networks are around in the near vicinity. And I can see here that my phone is showing up, which is great. So we just click on that. And then we just need to put the password. Now it may be called password or it may be called encryption key. Just look for something along those lines and put the Wi-Fi password or your personal hotspot password in there. So now we're connected to the internet. So that's the first step done. The next step is we need to go and look at our live platform because we need to retrieve two key pieces of information that's going to link the camera to that live platform. So I'm just going to move this camera to the side and then I'm going to go on YouTube just on my MacBook out of shot here. And what we're going to do, we're just going to go on Go Live and we're going to basically create a live test stream. I'm just going to put some details in. That'll do. And what we're looking for is, see now at the bottom of the page on the left hand side, we've got a stream key and a stream URL. And when we're using RTMP to stream, RTMP just means real-time messaging protocol. It is the most widely adopted language for live streaming video on the internet. That's what YouTube, Facebook, Vimeo, all the big players, they use this technology. And it's the same for these encoders that are built into the camera. So when YouTube gives me that stream URL and the stream key, I can literally take those two pieces of information and put it in any camera that has an encoder or any standalone encoder, and I'll be able to basically connect that to my YouTube live stream. So that's the next step. We go into the menu settings of the camera, and here we go. I can see I've got a field here to input some of this information. You're basically looking for something that says stream URL and stream key within your camera settings, and you simply copy and paste that information into your camera. Now, on some cameras, which is actually how this Panasonic works, I only have that one field. So if your camera only has the one field to enter this information, and you can't see anything else, or a separate one for the stream key, then usually that camera is expecting you to consolidate the two into that one field. So we just type in our stream URL, /, and then your stream key. And that's what I've just typed in here into this camera. So now we're kind of at the second to last step. We just now need to decide on the frame rate and the resolution and the bit rate that we want to stream at. Of course, we'll start the resolution first. That makes more sense. I want to stream at 1920 by 1080p. That's full HD. Now, if I go into my streaming formats available on this camera, I'm presented with a load of presets that I can choose between. Your camera might be the same, or it may allow you to make a fully customizable preset from scratch. But this one, I'm just gonna pick one of the presets. So I've got 1920 by 1080, that's full HD. That's what I wanna stream at. And then I wanna do it at 25 frames a second, which is what we call standard speed video, normal speed video. If you're filming sport or anything that's fast moving, you may want to do 50 frames a second because that's gonna resolve that motion much better than 25 frames a second. However, that is double the amount of frames per second, so it's gonna eat up a little bit more bandwidth to be able to do those extra frames. So we picked our resolution, we picked our frame rate, and then on this camera, you can see that we've got some numbers after those settings. I've got a 14M, a 6M, and a 1M, and that just corresponds to the bit rate, 14 megabits per second, 6 megabits per second, and 1 megabits per second. This is the amount of data that we're allocating per second to be able to encode that video and send it off. Now, before you can actually decide on which one you want to shoot at, or stream at, should I say, you need to do a speed test on your network. So just go to speedtest.net. It takes about 20 seconds, and that is the quickest way of getting your download and upload speed. And it's the upload speed that is key to live streaming, because of course, we're not downloading content, we're moving content from our network out into the internet. We're uploading that video and the audio, of course. So once we've got our upload speed, that'll give us an indication as to what megabits per second we can actually stream at. Your camera also might not tell you the bit rate in megabits per second. It may tell you in kilobits per second. It's a very easy conversion because it's just 1000 kilobits per megabit. So 6,000 kilobits, 6 megabits per second. So that's the way you convert if your camera says it in kilobits. So you can see on my network, I've got a very healthy upload speed. I'm gonna go for 6 megabits per second, which is actually what YouTube recommends for full HD at 25 frames a second. Now, if my internet upload speed was just coming in at 6 megabits per second, I don't want to be streaming at 6 megabits per second because of course there is absolutely no room for error there. And with networks, they don't deliver a constant speed. They do fluctuate up and down. And if it, of course, it goes down, then my encoder just doesn't have enough bandwidth to get all the information out that it's generating. And of course, your stream is gonna struggle then. So a general rule of thumb is to leave around about a 30 to 40% buffer on top of what you actually need. So if I'm gonna stream at 6 megabits per second, I'd be looking for an upload speed on my network connection of at least 8 megabits per second, around about that ballpark. So now all we need to do is go down in my menu and hit start. So that is now streaming to our live platform. If I go into YouTube, I can of course now see under stream health, it's picked up that my encoder, my camera is talking to YouTube. That's great. And we're still not getting a video or audio feed yet, but that will come. And there is a little bit of a delay before that happens. And it really depends on your encoder, your network connection, and the live platform. It can be anything from 10 seconds to a minute. So just bear with it, there will just naturally be a delay with streaming. And now, of course, I can see that we've got audio and video. And that camera is completely streaming wirelessly now to YouTube Live. And it is that straightforward. It doesn't really matter if you're streaming to YouTube, Facebook, or Vimeo, or what camera you're using. If that camera has a built-in live encoder, it's always going to be these same steps to get your content live from camera onto that platform. So I hope you found this video useful, guys. If you have, then hit that like button. That'd be lovely. And if you've got any questions, do just put them in the comments below and I'll do my best to get back to you. Thank you very much for watching.